Since I'm from humanities, I used to not know things concerning zoonotic diseases, antimicrobial resistance. So in a short while us interacting with our collaborative efforts, working together, I managed to learn a lot of things in relation to health with various students from various disciplines. I managed to learn from students of economics, students of agriculture, students of environment, how we can help, we can associate with our environment, animals, all in a short while, of which if I had to maybe study or paying money, it would be costly to me. So I appreciate the One Health concept. It really makes students learn a lot during a short time period on a free basis, if I'm to mean in terms of money. You come, you apply for the opportunity, you come and learn from the community members, you engage yourself with the community members, you identify the problems, you think through using various courses, students from various courses to identify with the community, also to identify possible solutions to solve those problems. And you learn a lot, leadership skills, teamwork skills, communication skills, how to engage with community members. So One Health is really a good concept.
I've gained a lot of experience from what we've been doing, always working with multidisciplinary people or people from different fields, because I personally, as a wildlife officer, I have come to know that really I cannot handle the challenges that communities have alone as a wildlife officer, because they are complex. They require many people to come in with different knowledges so that we can be able to handle issues of the communities.
During our first week in Bwera, we did a baseline assessment at Bwera General Hospital and Bwera School of Nursing and Midwifery about antimicrobial resistance. We found out that people are doing practices that lead to antimicrobial resistance, but they have inadequate information about antimicrobial resistance. We, the Bwera team, decided to sensitize people of Bwera Hospital community about what antimicrobial resistance is, the practices that lead to antimicrobial resistance, the dangers and ways they can use to prevent antimicrobial resistance. We also requested them to disseminate the information we had told them about antimicrobial resistance to their relatives, friends, and family members.
In the first place, as a nursing student and as a person from the medical background, I thought I knew it all. And I thought I never needed anyone else in health, like in improving health. But under the One Health Institute, I've been challenged, I should say. I've been challenged in that you look at a point whereby they're bringing in students from social sciences, from engineering, students from across that we used to call DOFs, because we under the medical schools, we used to call ourselves as geniuses. But you look at them as, we used to look at them as dwarfs. But now I'm looking at One Health bringing us together, and it has helped us to come together, bring in our inputs, and then bring put health at another level. During the attachment in Bwera, I've gained a lot of experiences as a medic. I thought it was all about receiving a patient in a hospital, but under One Health, I've gotten the competence of going into communities and getting to know what the challenges are, involving the community and seeing a way of resolving a health challenge.
I've had a chance to learn from my colleagues of very different disciplines, the medical people, the social sciences, the business people, and it has been very eye-opening. This is something that we don't always account for. one of our biggest challenges were how to help these people communicate better. They have their issues, they have their various medical personnel, but they don't talk to each other that much. So for example, the vets can be having a medical problem one side with the animals and the humans are having the same problem. For example, the problem of Brucella. The vets are reporting it and the humans are also medical personnel this side are reporting it. But they're not coming together to talk about it, that this is a zoonotic disease that the community is sharing. This, in the long run, gave I and a group of some of my groupmates an idea. What if we can develop a system for them to communicate better? That gave me the idea of the CMF, the community medical file. It's still a concept of a software on which the community members are members. They log on and communicate. My OSHA experience has been very informative and exciting. My team has been very active, very friendly. People are accepting. The challenges we had as working together, the frictioning, the I know best, I know what, I know this, I'm right, I'm wrong. We've learned our places in the society and we've worked together to help this community that we knew nothing about. A community we have learned from, that they have learned from us, and we are very appreciative, and it has been one of those experiences that you have once in a lifetime, but paves a way for you and a better life for everyone.
Since as a group leader for a team and as accountable for everything that was supposed to take place in Brera, I gained accountability skills where I came to realize that every single coin has to be accounted for, and I gained experience with working with different disciplines. I realized that health does not only apply to doctors but to everyone at large. I was so humbled that I got to know what social scientists are supposed to do. Before, I used to have a negative attitude about social scientists. I did not know they had a part to play in the health department. But I really feel we can work with anyone from every discipline, including social scientists, animal production department, human medicine, and veterinary medicine. I look forward to doing a master's in public health.
I've had a great experience working in CASESA with my team members. We have different backgrounds. We have social scientists and medical students, and I've had great experience learning from them. Let us say that social scientists, they are eloquent speakers, and I've learned a lot from them. The medical students know a lot in medicine. I've learned so much from them, and then working as a team has been great for me. When it came to cervical cancer vaccination, I really didn't know a lot the rationale of why they vaccinate children of 10 years. Yeah, and I learned a lot from the medical student. Yeah, I got great experience, knowledge, the rationale why they do the 10 years, that time frame it takes for cancer to appear. Yeah, so it was really great. Yeah, maybe from the social scientist, Leticia Nachemba. She's a great speaker. I've learned a lot from her, how to relate with people, with her children. Yeah,